A 20-year journey is nearing its end. But for the Comprehensive Nuclear Test Ban Treaty Organization, which monitors our entire planet for nuclear tests, the work is far from over. To complete its capability to hear nuclear explosions in the world's oceans, the CTBTO must first install a hydroacoustic monitoring station in one of the most remote places on Earth, the ocean floor, halfway between Africa and Antarctica. When completed, Hydroacoustic Station Number 4 at the Crozet Islands will join the CTBTO International Monitoring System to detect and alert the world of nuclear testing.
Installing a hydroacoustic station is a complex ocean engineering task. The hydroacoustic system we're installing at Crozet is one of six hydroacoustic stations, but these hydroacoustic stations are part of the International Monitoring System, which has over 300 stations listening for potential nuclear tests around the globe.
In the pursuit to develop more accurate and destructive nuclear weapons, over 2,000 nuclear bombs were detonated in the last half of the 20th century. But in 1996, the global community said enough and signed the United Nations Comprehensive Nuclear Test Ban Treaty. Today, 183 countries have voluntarily agreed to stop nuclear testing. But while signed in good faith, the mission of the CTBTO is to verify the treaty's compliance with hard data.
We're moving towards the final stages now of installing the HO4 station, but we were working in the roaring 40s, so the weather can be very unpredictable.
Those places, the roaring 40s, are legendary among sailors and people who work at sea as some of the most difficult oceans in the world. You have what is called an unlimited fetch, currents that are also merging, coming down from South Africa, merging with circumpolar currents that go all around the world, really undisturbed. In these difficult conditions was really something that put a lot of stress on everybody, on all the teams. You know that you're not allowed many mistakes.
Crozet is not only a harsh environment above the sea surface. It's also a harsh environment underwater. But we knew that we had a mission to accomplish, that was to install that station. Despite the difficulties, despite the harsh environment, the complexity of the project, we had to do it.
After more than 4 years of meticulous planning, two triplets of underwater microphones called hydrophones are finally loaded onto a specialized cable ship.
We have to be very careful loading our system on. We have a lot of cables connecting the system together. There's also some delicate electronics, the laser systems, etc. We have specialist crane operators and 10 people plus supporting the loading. And then we transit to the cable factory in Portsmouth.
It will take 3 days to load 120 kilometers of underwater cable. And another 5 weeks to reach the Crozet Islands in the South Indian Ocean.
Quand vous arrivez à Creuset avec ces centaines de manchots, c'est magique comme arrivée. Cette réserve naturelle a énormément d'importance pour la France. Elle permet de redonner aux îles leur caractère originel. Et c'est quelque chose d'extrêmement important. Pour cette nouvelle installation, TAF avait mis une personne pendant toute l'installation à nous accompagner afin de vérifier que toutes les opérations que nous faisions ne gênaient pas les animaux.
Several experts advised us that the good time to be there would be between December and February. However, it turns out that December was just apparently one of the worst ones they've ever had on record. Oh. What was happening there was that there were these systems brewing up south of South Africa and being launched by the wind towards us like frisbees. Freezing cold hurricanes with snow, hail. When the wind starts to be about more than 100 miles an hour, you have to go down and walk on all fours and work your way up, because dinner is up at the base.
Brief breaks between passing storms allow just enough time to deploy the hydrophones to the seafloor. When all systems are go, the ship releases the orange floats from their anchors, lifting the underwater microphones to their intended depths.
And then, bang, you see these things arrive, and then you start finally seeing data. So you start hearing whales, you suddenly have eyes underwater.
From the Indian Ocean down to the Arctic Sea, from the Atlantic to the Pacific, Hydroacoustic Station Number 4 at the Crozet Islands is now online, relaying data in real time to CTBTO headquarters in Vienna. The data is analyzed and shared with its test ban treaty member states almost as fast as it comes in. With 90% of its entire international monitoring system in place and its capability to monitor the world's oceans complete, the CTBTO can detect and alert the world to any potential nuclear test, anywhere on the planet, 24/7, 365 days a year.